Everyone, welcome back. In the last video, we learned how to find the perimeter of a square and a rectangle. But guess what? Not all shapes have equal sides. Today, we're diving into irregular shapes. We'll see how to find the perimeter when all sides are completely different. Not all shapes have equal sides. Some have different side lengths, and we call these irregular shapes. To find the perimeter of an irregular shape, we simply add up all the side lengths. There's no special formula, just add everything together. Look at this shape. An irregular triangle is a triangle with three sides of different lengths. In this example, the first side measures 5 centimeters, the second side measures 7 centimeters, and the third side measures 9 centimeters. To find the perimeter, we add all three side lengths together. When we add 5 centimeters, 7 centimeters, and 9 centimeters, the total is 21 centimeters. So, the perimeter of this irregular triangle is 21 centimeters. Another one. An irregular quadrilateral is a four-sided shape with different side lengths. In this example, the first side measures 6 centimeters, the second side measures 8 centimeters, the third side measures 5 centimeters, and the fourth side measures 7 centimeters. To find the perimeter, we add all four side lengths together. When we add 6 centimeters, 8 centimeters, 5 centimeters, and 7 centimeters, the total is 26 centimeters. So, the perimeter of this irregular quadrilateral is 26 centimeters. Yep, here is another one. An irregular pentagon is a five-sided shape where each side can have a different length. These shapes do not follow specific geometric rules like squares, rectangles, or equilateral triangles. In this example, the first side measures 4 centimeters, the second side measures 6 centimeters, the third side measures 5 centimeters, the fourth side measures 7 centimeters, and the fifth side measures 9 centimeters. To find the perimeter, we add all 5 side lengths together. When we add 4 centimeters, 6 centimeters, 5 centimeters, 7 centimeters, and 9 centimeters, the total is 31 centimeters. So, the perimeter of this irregular pentagon is 31 centimeters. Finding perimeter of an irregular shape is not hard, but a little bit of work. Let's look at our last example. An irregular hexagon is a six-sided shape where all the sides can have different lengths. In this example, the first side measures 3 centimeters, the second side measures 5 centimeters, the third side measures 4 centimeters, the fourth side measures 6 centimeters, the fifth side measures 7 centimeters, and the sixth side measures 8 centimeters. To find the perimeter, we add all 6 side lengths together. When we add 3 centimeters, 5 centimeters, 4 centimeters, 6 centimeters, 7 centimeters, and 8 centimeters, the total is 33 centimeters. So, the perimeter of this irregular hexagon is 33 centimeters. No matter what irregular shape you have, the process for finding the perimeter is always the same. Add up the lengths of all the sides. Remember to include the unit of measurement, like centimeters or inches. And that's a wrap for today's lesson. Now you know how to find the perimeter of any irregular shape just by adding up all its sides. Pretty simple, right? Remember, perimeter is just the total distance around a shape, no matter how many sides it has. So, whether it's a triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, or even a hexagon, just add up the sides and you've got your answer. In the next video, we'll take things a step further by solving real-world perimeter problems, so get ready to apply what you've learned. Make sure to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more fun math lessons. See you in the next one. Everyone, welcome back to Mathix Lab. In Perimeter Part 2, we explored different ways to calculate the perimeter of shapes. But guess what? There's more to learn. In this video, Parameter Part 3, we're diving even deeper, solving more examples and tackling irregular shapes. Look at this shape. A scalene triangle is a type of triangle where all three sides have different lengths. None of the sides are equal, so it's our job to figure out the sum of its perimeter. Let's take an example of a scalene triangle with the following side lengths. The first side measures 9 centimeters. The second side measures 6 centimeters. The third side measures 7 centimeters. Now, let's find the perimeter. To do this, we simply add the lengths of all three sides together. First, we add the first two sides, 9 centimeters plus 6 centimeters equals 15 centimeters. Now, we add the third side, 15 centimeters plus 7 centimeters equals 22 centimeters. And that's it. The perimeter of this scalene triangle is 22 centimeters. It's not wrong to arrange the figures the way you want, but make sure you don't miss any numbers. That is cool. Let's look at another example. A heptagon is a shape with 7 sides. If all the sides are not equal, we call it an irregular heptagon, meaning each side can have a different length. Here is an example of that. Let's say we have an irregular heptagon with the following side lengths. First side, 5 centimeters. Second side, 7 centimeters. Third side, 6 centimeters. Fourth side, 4 centimeters. Fifth side, 8 centimeters. Sixth side, 5 centimeters. Seventh side, 6 centimeters. To find the perimeter, we simply add up the lengths of all the sides. Add the first two sides. 5 centimeters plus 7 centimeters equals 12 centimeters. Add the third side. 12 centimeters plus 6 centimeters equals 18 centimeters. Add the fourth side. 18 centimeters plus 4 centimeters equals 22 centimeters. Add the fifth side. 22 centimeters plus 8 centimeters equals 30 centimeters. Add the sixth side. 30 centimeters plus 5 centimeters equals 35 centimeters. Add the last side, 35 centimeters plus 6 centimeters equals 41 centimeters. Final answer. The perimeter of this irregular heptagon is 41 centimeters. Oh, one thing I should point out, it's not wrong to add all the sides in any order you want. What I mean is, don't be confused about which number to add first. Just add them all, as long as you don't forget any of the numbers. A nonagon is a polygon with 9 sides. If the sides have different lengths, it is called an irregular nonagon because its sides are not equal. Example, let's say we have an irregular nonagon with the following side lengths. The first side is 4 centimeters. The second side is 6 centimeters. The third side is 5 centimeters. The fourth side is 7 centimeters. The fifth side is 3 centimeters. The sixth side is 8 centimeters. The seventh side is 6 centimeters. The eighth side is 4 centimeters. The ninth side is 7 centimeters. To find the perimeter, we add up all the side lengths. Add the first two sides. 4 centimeters plus 6 centimeters equals 10 centimeters. Add the third side, 10 centimeters plus 5 centimeters equals 15 centimeters. Add the fourth side, 15 centimeters plus 7 centimeters equals 22 centimeters. Add the fifth side, 22 centimeters plus 3 centimeters equals 25 centimeters. Add the sixth side, 25 centimeters plus 8 centimeters equals 33 centimeters. Add the seventh side. 33 centimeters plus 6 centimeters equals 39 centimeters. Add the eighth side. 39 centimeters plus 4 centimeters equals 43 centimeters. Add the ninth and last side. 43 centimeters plus 7 centimeters equals 50 centimeters. Final answer. The perimeter of this irregular nonagon is 50 centimeters. Last example. A decagon is a polygon with 10 sides. When the sides have different lengths, it is called an irregular decagon because not all sides are equal. Let's say we have an irregular decagon with the following side lengths. The first side is 5 centimeters. The second side is 7 centimeters. The third side is 4 centimeters. The fourth side is 6 centimeters. The fifth side is 8 centimeters. The sixth side is 5 centimeters. The seventh side is 7 centimeters. The eighth side is 6 centimeters. The ninth side is 4 centimeters. The tenth side is 8 centimeters. To find the perimeter, we add up all the side lengths. Add the first two sides. 5 centimeters plus 7 centimeters equals 12 centimeters. Add the third side. 12 centimeters plus 4 centimeters equals 16 centimeters. Add the fourth side. 16 centimeters plus 6 centimeters equals 22 centimeters. Add the fifth side. 22 centimeters plus 8 centimeters equals 30 centimeters. Add the sixth side. 30 centimeters plus 5 centimeters equals 35 centimeters. Add the seventh side. 35 centimeters plus 7 centimeters equals 42 centimeters. Add the eighth side. 42 centimeters plus 6 centimeters equals 48 centimeters. Add the ninth side. 48 centimeters plus 4 centimeters equals 52 centimeters. Add the tenth and final side. 52 centimeters plus 8 centimeters equals 60 centimeters. Final answer. The perimeter of this irregular decagon is 60 centimeters. Fun fact. The word decagon comes from the Greek words deka, meaning 10, and gonia, meaning angle. So, a decagon is simply a 10-sided shape with 10 angles. Sounds pretty cool, right?